right, dropped off Megan this morning. Got it off my truck pretty quick, like 40 minutes. Last time it took him 2 hours, so same exact loan. Talked to that broker, real nice guy. I'm not going to say his name, not going to call him out anymore. He did think it's funny that he says he's YouTube famous, but anyways, he said that the person that brought it to his attention was another carrier had emailed him and thought he'd like to know about it. So whichever carrier you are, I guess you're just that kind of person who likes to stir stuff up because it doesn't hurt anybody. You're trying to help the people out here get good loads, but that's nor here nor there. Not mad at you, but all kinds of people out here. So anyways, coming back out of Macon, he had another load for me. He was trying to get me back to Florida, but it was just too cheap. It was $1,250 on 450 miles down to Fort Pierce, which is the Miami side of, Atlantic side of Florida. That's just not worth it. I'd run that for about $1,750 maybe. So we were too far off on that one. But I started looking for loads, stopped at my Locust Grove, Griffin area, Highway 16 off of 75 coming up. There's that big marathon, the brand new one with the Dunkin' Donuts and Burger King. Stopped there, had some... I had a chicken sandwich and looking for loads. And then I found another one from C.H. Robinson. It's going right back home, Greenville, CNS Wholesale again. And it's a straight through, 6 p.m. So I was talking about a couple different loads, or searching a couple different loads. And J.B. Hunt rejected my load or my offer, which was 1,000 to Charlotte from Atlanta. And then Convoy had a load that was only going, I think it was 12 miles, I don't know exactly what it was, but it was Greenville to Simpsonville. Simpsonville is actually the city I live in. And it was $200 and then it went to $250 and I bid $400. And then I looked back at that load again and it was gone. So I figured someone else took it or what was ever going on. And in the process of emailing this other guy setting up this load that's taking me back home, it's $750, just right back to Greenville from Atlanta. I've been to this place before. Unfortunately, it's a very bad shipper. It's Sunny Delight, like warehouse. They don't make it there. They just hold it, but it takes them forever to load. So he had a 7 a.m. appointment that was already passed, and those guys would have been working, but then he had a 1:30 appointment. And my ETA, I'll be there about 12:50. So if I can get that 1:30 and hopefully they can get it on the truck quickly, then I can get home straight through 6 o'clock, CNS Wholesale, and still be in time to take the wife to dinner tonight for her birthday. So... looks like it's all going to work out, but this will all depend on good old Sunny Delight and CNS Wholesale. But it brings it back to the point that these brokers kind of, or these apps, brokers, apps, both the same thing, make these loads disappear, make me think you're going to lose it, and then I get an email confirmation saying my bid is accepted for that load for $400 going from Greenville to Simpsonville, right as I'm getting the rate confirmation from C.H. Robinson for the $750 going back to Greenville. So I'd rather take the $750. I know it's a heavy load, it's 41,000, but it's twice the money for about $50, maybe $40 more fuel. So I will take that. Plus it's a straight through. The Simpson, Greenville to Simpsonville was the next day, 10 a.m. delivery in the morning. And it's to a pallet place. It was just empty pallets going back to the pallet manufacturer. But all right, that was my rant for the day, or my rates for the day. Get me back home, get me back for the birthday. I was just gonna go right back home and try to pick something up in the area, heading out to Florida for a 2 day or something, but this will be even better. I'll get loaded right now and I'll be home tonight for a straight through and get the wife a nice steak dinner. She loves those fillets, rare, medium rare. So I'll get her one of those, some asparagus, and make her happy. All right, guys, stay safe out there. God bless, and keep trucking. Here it is, straight across this road. So we're lucky enough to get a little opening. That's a four-lane highway with some fast-running traffic. If you ever come down here, though, this is Sunny Delights right here on the right. You will see, talk about a tight facility. Oh, man, and you have to park on the street to check in. I mean, look at this curve. I can't show you, but the whole thing is dug out from people making shallow turns. And my tires are barely gonna miss it. Good. Yeah, right up here on the right as it dips down. Sunny Delights. It's definitely a tight one, so But they're paying pretty good to go back to CNS, and hopefully they can get me loaded quick so I can make that 6 o'clock and get the wife out for some food in her belly, because then she's happy, and then I'm happy. But yeah, if you can see right down there on the right, that is CNS, where that red truck's pulling out. Oh yeah, tight, tight. Park out here in the street and get checked in. All right, guys. So yeah, I just got checked in, and if I didn't have this 1:30 appointment, I would be waiting like this poor guy who doesn't have an appointment time. And there's three other trucks out there on the street that are all trying to come in here. So when you're doing your booking your loads last minute, make sure you, if you come to a place like this where it's a grocery or water or anything like that, make sure your appointment is close to when you're going to be there if you want to get out of there before the end of the night. So she says next door that comes available, which there's like 6 trucks right here, I'll be in there. So yeah, make sure your appointments are on point. There was a 7 a.m. for this load, and there was a 1:30, and I was gonna ETA get here about 12:50, which I did. So luckily I'll have the next door and get in there. But if I didn't have that 1:30, I'd be waiting. So pay attention to your appointment times, rule the day. Well, I'm topping off the tanks, good old Anderson in South Carolina. QT, and with fuel being so cheap, I went from Greenville to the house. Oh, I don't focus. Whatever, $229 for $506. So I went to Tampa, back up from Jacksonville. Both the Tampa one wasn't that heavy, but the back from Jacksonville was pretty heavy. And I went to Macon, south of Atlanta, and now back to Greenville. Or Anderson on $500. I'm crossing my fingers fuel stays that cheap, but probably won't. But I like the fuel in South Carolina. Well, I gotta get my cup. It's just all a lot cheaper. It's $2.29. Where are you gonna find that? I know IFTA kind of equals it out, but just good. QT has good fuel, and that's what I do. So I'm gonna go pay for this stuff, deliver this load, and get that wife to her birthday dinner. If I can get it unloaded quick enough. All right, guys, God bless. And she's full of fuel. So, as you can see, I did make it home for the birthday girl. Look at those pants. Let's take her in the halls. Yeah. I get hit by a motorcycle. Turn the lights off. Downtown Greenville, if you ever get a chance, pretty cool spot. Show us that outfit, girl. Oh man, nicely done. Going to halls. I can't wait to see this place when it's done. It's some new like office space and residential. All right, we made it. Happy birthday, girl. And you guys keep trucking.